It is my new donor. This morning is my privilege to present to us the WSF study guide for the month of May. The prophetic focus for the month of May is, I am blessed to be a blessing. Can we echo it together? I am blessed to be a blessing. And the anchor scripture, 2 Corinthians 9 and verse 8. Our study series for the month is entitled The Blessings That Accompany a Given Life. And we're looking at that from the anchor scripture, Philippians 4, verse 15 to 19. By way of introduction, it's important to note that giving provides access to having all sufficiency in all things. 2 Corinthians 9 makes it very clear that God loves a cheerful giver, and as we do so, He multiplies us and gives us sufficiency in all things. But the covenant of giving and receiving goes far beyond financial returns. And this is what we are going to be looking at in detail in the course of this month. Note also that the blessing of the Lord does not only make rich, but it adds no sorrow. Proverbs 10 and verse 22. So we are going to be looking at this subject in the four Saturdays of the month of May. And on the first Saturday, being the 5th of May, we are going to be looking at two aspects of blessings that accompany giving. Number one is that giving averts curses and plagues. Giving averts curses and plagues. In Genesis 8, verse 20 to 22, after the flood had come upon the earth, the Bible says that Noah offered the sacrifice before the Lord, and the Lord said, I will no longer curse the earth for man's sake. But as long as the earth remains, seed time and harvest shall not cease. Also in 2 Samuel 24, verse 24 and 25, we are made to understand that a curse was upon the nation of Israel, but David offered a sacrifice before the Lord, and the curse was averted. Whatever represents a curse shall be averted in this month in the name of Jesus. Amen. Secondly, giving empowers for divine health. Giving empowers for divine health. In Psalm 41, verse 1 to 3, the Bible makes clear there, it said, the one who gives, among other things, it said, the Lord will deliver him in a time of trouble and make all of his bed in his sickness, which empowers him for supernatural health. In Ephesians 6 and verse 8, whatever good thing any man does, the Bible says, the same will he receive of the Lord, whether he's bond or free. In this same month, whatever represents sickness or disease in the life of anyone within our various home cells shall be eradicated in the name of Jesus Christ. Let's remember that the WSF meeting is interactive. Therefore, engagement of everyone present is very important and vital. The second Saturday, being the 12th of May, we're looking at two other aspects of the blessings that accompany a given life. And first of all, we are seeing the fact that giving guarantees divine protection. So with me, giving guarantees divine protection. In Psalm chapter 20, verse 1 to 3, the Bible makes it clear to us there. It said, the Lord heard thee in the day of trouble, the name of the God of Jacob defend thee, send thee help from the sanctuary, strengthen thee out of Zion. And all of this comes from remembering all your offerings and your burnt sacrifices. So every time we offer our offerings, our givings before the Lord, God remembers it for our defense. God shall remember your givings for your defense in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. In Job 22 also, we see there in verse 24, having represented there the covenant of giving. In verse 24, he said that thou shalt lay up gold as dust and the gold of offer as the stones of the brooks. And what will happen in verse 25, he said, the Almighty shall be thy defense and thou shalt have plenty of silver. It means that as you and I continue in the giving covenant, God guarantees us supernatural protection. Number two aspect that we look at that accompanies giving the giving life for this second Saturday is giving secures longevity. Say with me, giving secures longevity. Say louder, giving secures longevity. In Isaiah chapter 65, verse 20 to verse 24, we see there very clearly that among other things, God has packaged a life of longevity. He said, for as the days of a tree, he said, so also shall be the days of my people. And a child shall die at 100, he said, and there will be no one that will suffer infant of days. But for that to take place, in Exodus 23, verse 25 and 26, we are made to understand that you will serve the Lord your God. That includes our material service. And he will bless your bread and water. He will take sickness away from the midst of thee. And he said in verse 26, among other things, that the number of thy days he will fulfill. So every time we commit ourselves to serving God and doing so, including our material service through giving, God guarantees the security of longevity. Everyone shall be a partaker of longevity in the name of Jesus. No one in our home cell will have their days cut short. The third week of this month, being the 19th of May 2018, we are taking two other blessings that accompany a giving life. Number one here is that giving engenders supernatural fruitfulness. Giving engenders supernatural fruitfulness. And the reference scriptures we have, 2 Kings chapter 4, verse 7 to 18. The Shunammite woman had provided a room and provided gifts for Elisha to serve God through serving him. And as she did that, Elisha asked, what is it that this woman needs? And suddenly, his servant Gehazi said, she has no child and her husband is old. And he said, by this time, according to the time of life, you shall be with a child. The woman had lost all hope. But fruitfulness was restored by giving life. Therefore, we can expect supernatural fruitfulness to answer in the name of Jesus. In Psalm 127 verse 3, the Bible makes it clear that the fruit of the womb is his reward. So every time we serve God, among other things, by our material resources, we position ourselves for supernatural fruitfulness. There shall be no barrenness in any area of anyone's life in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Number two, giving secures the destiny of our generations yet unborn. Giving secures the destiny of our generations yet unborn. In Psalm 112, which is a covenant picture of a giver's life, beginning from verse 1 to 3, it said, praise the Lord, blessed is the man that fears the Lord and delights greatly in his commandment. What happens to him, his seed shall be mighty upon the earth. The generation of the upright shall be blessed. Wealth and riches shall be in his house, he said, and his righteousness endureth forever. And verse 9 of that same scripture makes it clear. He said, he has dispersed, he has given to the poor, his righteousness endureth forever, and his horn shall be exalted with honor. God is making it clear to us from these scriptures that everyone who engages in this covenant of giving not only secures the prosperity of the present, but the prosperity of their children after them. In other words, the giving covenant secures not only prosperity, but also posterity. And that shall be our experience in the name of Jesus Christ. In Proverbs chapter 20, verse 7, the Bible makes us to understand. It said, the just man walks in his integrity and his children are blessed after him. That will be our own experience in the name of Jesus. All of this is secured primarily via our engagement of the giving covenant. And finally, on the fourth Saturday of this month, being the 26th of May, 2018, we shall be looking at these two other aspects of the blessings that accompany a given life. Number one is that giving triggers the flow of divine favor. Giving triggers the flow of divine favor. in Psalm 37 and verse 7. Psalm 37 and verse 7. He said, rest in the Lord and wait patiently for him. He said, fret not thyself because of him that prospereth in the way and the man that bringeth wicked devices. And Luke chapter 6 and verse 38, it tells us there, give and it shall be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, shall men bring unto your bosom. He said, for with the same measure that you meet, it will also be measured back unto you. So every time we engage practically in the covenant of giving, we secure, among other things, divine favor. I see the favor of God decorating every one of us in this month in the name of Jesus. Number two blessing that we'll be examining on that Saturday is that giving secures all-round rest. It secures what? All-round rest. In 2 Chronicles chapter 15, beginning from verse 12, the Bible tells us there, 12 to 15, it said, and they entered into a covenant to seek the God of their fathers, and they did it with all their heart. They had entered into this covenant to seek him, to serve him, not just with their energy, but also with their resources. And what was the effect of it in verse 15? He said, and the Lord gave them rest round about. So every commitment to the covenant of giving secures all round rest. In Philippians chapter 4, verse 15 and also verse 19, the Bible makes us to understand there, he said, that no one communicated in giving and receiving, but you only, speaking of the Philippians. And he said in verse 19, by that engagement, he said, my God shall supply all your need, not only financial, but every need. So giving secures all-round rest. It means that any area of life that would have been in unrest, as we engage the covenant of giving, God supplies what is required to give rest there. As we engage this giving covenant, every area that may have suffered unrest, I see God granting rest in every such area. Somebody believe it, say loud amen. I said somebody believe it, say loud amen. Let us remember that all through, in all of our engagement and interactions, we are ensuring that there is participation from everyone within the home cell. You take the points, you allow individuals to read some portions of the scriptures, you allow people to comprehend the points that are being communicated, and as we do so, each one of us shall be growing in deeper knowledge of the truth of the giving covenant and walking into greater dimensions of the blessings that lie therein in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Will you lift up your right hand to the Lord right now and ask God for grace to be effective in communicating these truths unto everyone in the home cells this month? Lord, as I will speak, grant me utterance, grant me effectiveness in communicating this truth in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Ask the Lord right now for it. Ask the Lord right now for it. Utterance is available as we call upon him. He will grant us that which is necessary to communicate the intention of God to everyone we come across in our home cells. Each one will come to the point of understanding. Greater depths and light will be shining forth in each one of our locations, and the blessings that are being spoken of will be practically manifested. Father, thank you. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' precious name we have prayed. It shall be a glorious time in his presence, in Jesus' name. Give Jesus a big hand.